Coming up on the channel today, Lauren is going to stop by and share her top five Beatles songs. Not top five Beatles songs, but top five solo songs by Beatles. Coming right up. Hey, it's Russ from the Infectious Groove Podcast and YouTube channel. And y'all know Lauren. She had the nerve to roll in here with a Ringo shirt on, which means that she's probably going to have a Ringo pick or two. And she is here today to share with us her, maybe not top five, but five great solo songs from the Fab Four, correct?
Yes, yes. Just ones I think that don't get enough attention.
Because, yeah, I feel like for all four Beatles, there are definitely hits and maybe songs that weren't even hits at the time, but still everyone knows.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're going outside those lines to share more.
Yeah, these right are on. Not those.
Right on. Okay. Shoot, what are some songs people need to hear from the Beatles?
Okay, first, it should come as no surprise that my first song is 6 o'clock from Ringo. And I love this song for a couple of reasons. Number one, the album that it's off of, Ringo, from 1974, is the closest the Beatles got to getting back together. Every single Beatle is on this record, and Paul actually wrote this song, and I think it's just so pretty. You can tell Paul wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
But Ringo also lays down a really sweet vocal here.
Oh, that's cool.
So.
Yeah, I... Of everything Ringo did with the Beatles, I love his vocal on Don't Pass Me By.
Mm-hmm.
So anything along those lines is good by me. What else do you got?
Yeah. So for George, this was tough because George's music, it is kind of all over the place in a lot of ways. And mm-hmm. so I decided to go Silly George, being who I am. So sure. I went with Cracker Box Palace from 33 and a Third in 1976. And the first time I heard this song was actually when I was watching an old episode of Saturday Night Live hosted by Eric Idle.
Oh, yeah.
He did the video for Cracker Box Palace. It's so weird.
Yeah.
It's very weird. And this song is just fun, goofy, silly George. It makes you remember that, yeah, George is silly.
We also had a sense of humor.
Yes.
Yeah. And this is a weird equation to make, but there's somebody like Prince. No one ever thinks of his sense of humor. And with George, I feel like most people think of him as so serious and sullen. And mm-hmm. so it's cool to have a fun choice.
Yeah, yeah. George is more fun than people give him credit for. I mean, he was very involved with Monty Python.
So. Oh, yeah, for sure. So there are two Beatles you have not touched on yet.
Yes, I'm going to touch on Paul now. Mm-hmm. And I'm going more recent Paul.
Mm-hmm.
His Memory Almost Full album from 2007, like, I absolutely loved. So I went with Only Mama Knows off of this because it's a Paul rocker.
Yeah.
And I think it's just as good as some of the rock stuff that Paul put out, you know, with Wings.
I don't mean this in any sort of derogatory way, but when Lauren played it for me, the first thing I said was, oh, I see Paul heard Vertigo by U2. And again, I mean that in a complimentary way. So if you've heard Vertigo by U2, check this track out because it's like you said, it's Paul rock. Like when I first heard Vertigo, I was like, oh, U2 remember how to rock.
Mm-hmm.
So I get the same vibe from Paul that he was like, yeah. Yeah, I should rock again.
Yes, I should rock again. And you accidentally made a beautiful segue to my fourth.
That's what I do.
Pick. Yeah. So my John Lennon pick for this is Meat City from Mind Games in 1973. And this is John Lennon remembering, oh, I do know how to rock.
Right on.
It's just a straight up rocks. And the reason I went with Meat City is because, number one, it's super fun to listen to. And number two, in my mind anyway, Meat City is the song that made him do the rock and roll album that he put out, like where he's just covering old rock songs.
Right, right.
And so this is like, oh yeah, I remember how to do that. I like doing that. I'm going to do more of that.
And again, Lennon is one of those guys that is known for the serious side of things and, you know, protest and really using his platform to say something. So it is cool when an artist like that can be like, you know what though? Fun and rock.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
So how are you going to round out these five songs?
You know, I just had this thought in this moment. I should have picked like a Billy Preston song or something.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
But I didn't. I picked another Ringo song because I am who I am and I'm not apologizing for it. And the song I went with is from the Ringo-Rama. Yes, I know. It's called Ringo-Rama. The Ringo-Rama album in 2003. And it's a track called Instant Amnesia.
Mm-hmm.
And I bought this on CD when it came out, and I absolutely ate it up. And here's the thing with Ringo. Ringo is very good at surrounding himself with very good musicians. Mm-hmm. And that is so clear on the entirety of this album. But I think especially this song, because it's very Revolver. It's very White Album. This is Ringo saying, I'm a Beatle.
Right. And that was, when I first heard the song, that was my thing, was I'm a huge fan of Revolver and the White Album. And I instantly was like, oh yeah, this is Ringo being like, yeah, there's my heritage.
Instantly, and then you forgot, right? Because of the instant amnesia?
Instant amnesia, yeah. Yes. So there are 5 songs from the Fab Four that you should look into that, again, are not Instant Karma or, you know, Maybe I'm Amazed. These are songs that people probably haven't heard. And I don't think I'd heard most of these before Lauren played them for me, and I thought they were great. What are some of your favorite solo Beatles songs? We don't need any more Ringo, so you can just pick from George, Lies, and Paul, and John. And leave us a comment below. We love to hear that. We've got a lot of good feedback since Lauren joined the channel, which we greatly appreciate. And as we always say in these videos, thank you so much for watching.